sea turtle, only 7 inches long, is the first known sea turtle to be rescued from the Gulf oil slick. Right now, they are cleaning up the endangered Kemp Ridley turtle in New Orleans. Dr. Reese Halter is a conservation biologist at Cal Lutheran University. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Alex.
Okay, these are the pictures we do not want to see in terms of animals covered with oil, but is it going to happen? Is it just inevitable we're going to see more of this?
Yeah, tough being a critter. Look, this morning what we're doing is we're waiting for the more than four dozen necropsies, the animal equivalent of an autopsy, to be released. And, you know, there's a couple things we need to understand, Alex. At this time of year, what we're seeing is three times the death rate that's normal, number one. Number two, oil contains a suite of toxic chemicals, including known cancer-causing agents. Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, very toxic. When we add dispersant to the ocean right now, what we're doing is we're spreading this poison way beyond the slick. That means plants like algae and animals like fish, squid, jellyfish, and sea squirts, the same food that the five species of sea turtles eat, is toxic.
Okay, let's look at some stats here, because they're going to be the doubters, because these sea turtles that have washed ashore, of which there were 162, 156 of them have died, they're not necessarily covered in oil. And Reese, on average in the month of May, you're going to get 47 dead sea turtles in the region. So how sure are you that there can be a link between the Gulf oil mess and the dead turtles?
Well, as I said, we're waiting for the necropsies to be released, but we're not talking about them being saturated in oil, Alex. We're talking about what they're eating, and their food source is contaminated. The other thing is, you know, we've got to stop pounding hundreds of gallons of this dispersant into the ocean, because it's headed towards the third largest coral reef on planet Earth, the Floridian corals. And remember, those corals contain powerful pain and cancer medicines and 600 or 700 animal species.
Okay, Reese Halter, we know you're on the case. Thanks so much. I'm sure we'll talk with you again.
Thank you.